Hello, my name is Lena Atutola, and I'm the assessment coordinator for the Inglewood Unified School District, which is a small district in Southern California. This video is about the process for creating users. Our past practice has been to have site test coordinators fill out a Google Sheet with the names and email information of every credentialed teacher at the site. This is used to upload the CAASPP role of test administrator into TOMS as a batch upload. The district test coordinator sends an email to all teachers notifying them that their new role has been created, the process for confirming the role, and what the responsibilities are attached to that role. We had chosen the CAASPP test administrator role because it allows the teachers to not only administer all interim and summative assessments, but also verify test settings on the test administrator interface and have access to test completion reports in TOMS. Once the CAASPP Moodle training becomes available, the test coordinators cross-reference the list of current CAASPP test administrators with the list of individuals who have completed the Moodle training. Only those who completed the Moodle training were able to keep their CAASPP test administrator role. Those who did not complete the training had their roles removed prior to the opening of the summative administration window. However, for the upcoming school year, we are going to try a different system because we would like to limit the access to the CAASPP test administrator role to only those who have completed the Moodle certification. This is our new plan. At the beginning of the year, we will upload the file with the teacher information, but this year with an interim assessment administrator only role so that they may administer the IABs prior to the summative window opening. Once the CAASPP Moodle training becomes available and teachers are able to complete the certification process, the test coordinators will update the roles of individuals who submit their Moodle certificates for CAASPP test administrator roles. Next year will be our first year trying it. Our school district has about 300 CAASPP users. We often have a high number of substitutes and like to have a plan for how to administer assessments if a classroom teacher is absent during an administration window. For this reason, we have all teachers complete Moodle certification training so that they can be CAASPP test administrators. This includes teachers of non-testing grades, grades UTK through 2. In the event that a credentialed teacher is not available to administer a CAASPP assessment, a substitute can cover another teacher's class, and the credentialed teacher who has already completed training can step in and administer the assessment for that class's testing period. For the summative ELPAC, we wait until the Moodle certification becomes available for the summative ELPAC. Once teachers complete the Moodle certification for summative ELPAC and submit their certificate, we then create their roles for the test exam. Thanks for watching. I hope you found this information timely and useful.